I want to get an idea from you.
No, I think that's good.
What you want him to do.
He kind of does that. He kind of just sort of walks around. He looks down at R2.
For episode one, C-3PO was a puppet. It was done in the Bunraku style, Japanese puppeteering, where the puppet is actually suspended in front of the puppeteer and through a series of linkages to the body mimics how that person moves.
Master Anakin, you are my maker, and I wish you well. However,
on episode two, we were meant to use the puppet once again. And initially, there was some concern that whether or not Tony could do it physically because of his stature. So I was going to puppeteer it. But Tony asked if he can try it. And so we let him try it with the rig that we had. And I was also the idea of having to wear that thing in the desert. Didn't appeal to me, so I was like more than happy to let Tony wear it. It was amazing to watch Tony puppeteer it, because even though it was heavy and even though it wasn't him in the costume, all of a sudden the puppet looked more like C-3PO than anybody else could have done. And then he puppeteered it for the film, which ultimately was cut out and replaced. Those scenes were replaced with him in the suit.
I am C-3PO, human cyborg relations.
And then the suit was actually, for episode two, was actually an Empire Strikes Back suit that we just simply painted.
Oh, my. Hello. It's so nice to be back.
And that was, again, one of those quick rush jobs where we were told, I think, on Friday what it was supposed to look like, and it had to be on set on Monday.
3116 Charlie, take one. Hey, Mark.
Mark.
Set.
Set. And action. There.
Not quite.
Sorry, guys. Still rolling.